The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. What a game so far we're seeing from Blotch.
Seemed like he made everything he got. I mean, anytime he had an open look, he took advantage of the opportunity there in that first half.
And Steve, they were all good looks. I mean, his shot selection has been terrific throughout the game.
It has been a little ragged, just 38% from the field. Outside, Scola, five to shoot. Hooked down low that time, and he got the 3 second bump.
You know, sometimes the intensity of the game can lead to brain neutral plays like that, guys.
Here's Perez. The shot, no good. Number 8. A striking finish under heavy pressure all over. He's got 12. Clark and Steve, either side has relented a bit in this back and forth affair.
Well, 8 lead changes, Kevin, so far as the teams are battling it out here in the third.
That's all building towards what could be a great finish. This will be fun to watch.
Watch. And so he earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact and he'll shoot 2. He's made 2 of 3 from the stripe tonight. And the first one at the line is good. He doesn't get the second one.
Well, he could have done a little better on that trip to the foul line, but he was able to tie this game up.
And a foul call on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
And the defense looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Yeah, I like that. A foul to save the layup. Make him earn it at the line.
Both good from the line that time. Second half of basketball, just over a minute played so far. Pass to Perez. Releases from 15. Scola with the rebound. Scola's got his 6th rebound on the night.
And offensively, they have yet to hit a shot. Slow start here in the second half.
On up the court.
Well, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition. Well, he may just be trying to get a break in the action to clear their heads. A lot of their shots are rimming out. You wonder if their confidence isn't suffering at this point.
I think that's a good time to call a timeout. If the team has a few fall the wrong way for them, just burn a timeout and let them forget about it. Regroup, talk about it, and refocus.
Beyond the arc. Number 29. Drains it from beyond the arc. He's got a layup.
Of all the guys you want to leave open out on the perimeter, he is the absolute last guy on the list. Attention to detail. Know your personnel.
He did not look too happy about some of the things he saw on the court. So I would expect some changes here.
I think it's the right move, quite honestly. I mean, they just didn't look sharp or at their best out there. So take the time out and give yourself a chance to regroup.
Passes it to Aguilar. He gets the shot to fall. The defender wasn't set. He's called for the block and a 3-point play chance here. 3 trips to the line so far for him in this one. In a mediocre 41% in this one, doubled by Perez. Outside Scola, defended by Aguiar, fade away, and the basket by Scola. Scola's got his 2nd bucket of the night.
Perfect on their first 3 shots now. That's the way to start the second half.
Watch backing down. He passes to Aguilar. Here's Perez. And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Here's Scola.
That misses off the backboard.
They've been able to get out to this lead without really getting a very reliable performance out of him from the field.
Number 20. And not sure what he was thinking there. On 3 or 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. Goes up after a two-handed dunk.
Tremendous start from the guy Clark, we think more of for his passing.
Yeah, but he's got tremendous leaping ability and a surplus supply, too.
Well, that's a great aggressive move and two big points, too.
Number 3, guarded by Scola. Blocks with a screen on Scola. Aguilar. And foul hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Talk about complete control. Everything working in this one for Blocks.
He's got 16 points, and he has sent a bunch of shots in reverse.
Well, and because of that, there's now a serious intimidation factor working in their favor.
And both free throws good from Blocks.
The story in the first half was their low free throw percentage. They've corrected that here in the second half, and hopefully they can build on it as this game continues to progress.
Number 3. And they're running, pushing it up. And it's going to be out of bounds. And they'll keep possession. Number 10, defended by Perez. Number 12, lays it up and brings it in. 7 points in the game.
And defensively, they're starting to look for answers because ever since halftime, they've been disjointed out there.
Here's Blotch. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Went for the two-hander on that slam. That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Yeah, he's sensing this is a critical time in this game, guys.
Pass to Scola. The short one's on the money. Scola's got 6. Getting blanked from free throw line so far in the third. Still 0-for-3. There's the screen by Blotch. The pass to Perez. Shot clock at 6. Number 20. No good from the wing.
He can't get anything to drop. And the way he's going, I'm not sure it's something he should try to shoot his way out of.
No, that might only serve to make things worse, Steve. Sometimes the harder you try, the worse it gets. Looks to me like they hit the refresh button here in the second half after shooting less than 40% from the field before the break.
Well, they managed to hold down the fort defensively, and now their offense is finally starting to kick into groove.
And it looks to me like he still has some of the shooting touch that he displayed in the first.
Number 7. It's rebounded by Aguilar. On 1-4 and 3-point shots here in the third. To tie. Here's Blotch. Passes to Aguilar. Perez, the pass to Aguilar. Dishes to Blotch. And they finally get it to go. A full night's work on the boards in one trip down the floor. Gone 7 of 11, a lucky field goal percentage here in the third. Number 9. That one off the back iron and out.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
1:32 left in the third. Kicks it to Blotch. Pass to Aguilar. Scola on him for the lead. Scola with the rebound. Third quarter has been growing up around 58%. Blotch 106 left to play in the third. Number 10. Can't hit the turnaround jumper. And 31% here in the third. Offensively, they are looking bleak. Passes it to Perez. Free throw line jump shot. Can't hit.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Number 10. Gets an open look and hits.
Well, they were getting tired out there. Quick timeout gives them an opportunity to catch their breath.
There's 37 seconds left in the third quarter of the game.
Come on, he's traveling.
Number 5.
Shot clock is off. This should be the last possession of the quarter.
That's what they should have in mind here.
Now the dish to Stola. Let's it go from the wing. No luck. Number 5. We got it up that time, but it wouldn't fall for him. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. The home team leading by 3. 2K Sports back in a moment here at the Time Warner Cable Arena in Charlotte. Feeds to Scola. 6 on the shot clock. Fires top of the key. And he overshot that one, missing.
That's his comfort zone, so defensively, really nice job challenging the shot.
There's the pass to Aguilar. That is good. And so here's the home team. They lead by 1. Front pass the arc. It's rebounded by Blatch. Blatch has got 5 rebounds tonight. Number 8. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. And 2 shots coming up. That one drops. He ties it up. So he picks up just 1 from the line that time.
Misses the line. Might stick in his craw for a while. Always hurts to miss a chance to take the lead. And you know, these calls can be some of the toughest in the game for the officials.
It all happened so fast, but I really think that was the right call. The defender was not really set in that situation.
Number 29. Rebounded by Blatch, being a respectable 47% from the field in this one. Just over a minute and a half play here in the fourth. And that one's good.
Well, I like the way he orchestrated in tight that time, fellas.
Gone 0-3 to start the fourth quarter. Outside, Scola. They get the rebound.
Come on, guys.
Inside. Up and in.
That's one of the going to be all about hard work from this point on. They worked hard to create that high-quality shot right there.
Yeah, and that's their goal down the stretch. Continue to find those close-range shots.
Number 8. And he's good on the rebound.
They've been scoring on those threes since halftime.
Definitely. Big improvement in their shooting from what we saw before the break.
Now, here's Blotch. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Number 20. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
Terrific play right there. Great strength to finish through the hip.
That's how you do it. The bump and the bucket.
And the home team has possession. Fourth quarter keeps moving right along. 3 minutes gone so far. The feed to Scola. Number 8. Goes back up. Can't get the layup. Gotten all three of their shots to drop here in the fourth quarter. They came out of the break on a roll. Pass to Aguilar. Number 3. Knocks down the 3-ball. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back.
This has really become an intense ball game ever since halftime.
Boy, the effort from both teams here, Steve, is terrific.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Hi, guys. I got a chance to hear what the home team head coach was saying to his players. He wants them to pick it up and really go for it right now, saying, no time like the present, gentlemen. Embrace it. Embrace the spotlight and let's make it.
And thank you, Doris. And he drew the blocking foul. We'll go to the line for two. Both.
This is a positive trend for him, especially here in the second half, shooting just above 80% right now. And that's more than respectable. That's good free throw shooting.
Number 8 drains the free throw. He's got 21.
It's been a humongous fourth quarter for him, especially from long range. He's in a groove, and that play of his has just been dead.
Here's Aguilar. Excellent D there for Scola. Gone 4-10 here in the final period. Not the time to go cold. To the middle. Number 12. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
At the line for your Bobcats, shooting two. Number 12.
That free throw missing. Sinks the second.
Even with the miss, he got the big one there to put him in front.
Gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. He kicks to Blotch. Number 3. Good on the three-point shot. And guys, here in the fourth quarter, still a close game.
Yeah, and actually still too close to call. I mean, this one is tight.
This could be an instant classic, fellas. I mean, this thing has all the looks of a game that's going to go right down to the last shot.
He feeds it to Blotch. Number 3. No good from outside.
They've been strong on the boards. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says. Still anybody's game, though.
Number 20.
And what was that about? Not a good shot right there. Gotten the three-point bug tonight. They've taken 15 shots outside the arc. 6 of 15. He dishes it to Scola. Defended by Aguiar. It's rebounded by Aguiar. Gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. Number 20. The layup missed. In a paltry 33% in the fourth, not a good showing for this offense. For the three. Offensive rebound. Number 8. No good with the triple. Gone 5 for 9 from the field in the final quarter so far. We've got 1:55 left in the fourth quarter. Gets it to go.
He's been ready to do work in the fourth quarter.
It's delightful to see him watch.
They don't seem to have any answers for him. We need to review their game plan and look for a way to cool him off.
Number 8, defended by Correll. .43 left in the fourth quarter. Number 29. Misses and the dry spell continues.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
No, that's for sure, because this guy's too good of a shooter to miss that one consistently.
Perez, the pass to Aguilar. It's going to be 2 free throws, 2 contact on the shot. First one drops, and that puts them up by 5. Second one is good. Running both at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Those foul shots put them that much more in the driver's seat.
They get a hand on it. A good screen. Down low. He hits the first one, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And so he drops them both. It's an 8-point game. 59 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Number 7. Sinks it. Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 4.
And that kind of defense is just not going to cut it, because they have to get a hand in his face.
Passes it to Perez. Scola with the rebound.
Well, ever since the second half started, he's been ice cold. Very little going his way right now.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Number 29. What a beautiful shot to bring him to within 3.
Wow. Huge shot. Listen to this crowd.
It sounds like a rock concert in here.
Well, they've been waiting to explode all game, and they finally got reason to do so. Well, you do what you have to do to extend this game and try to get the ball back.
In this situation, clock management, crucial.
That's good, ball. 1-2 from the line, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. The three. Launches a three. Yes! And that shot brings them to within just one. 5 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul. Good on the first, and that will put them up by two. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 3-point game.
Absolutely massive free throw. That'll force them into a 3-pointer.
And so the road team gets the W in this one. It was tight, but they managed to come up with the win.
Nobody wants to lose in most games. It's much better to win.